Hi, Mike. Good morning, Nikki. Good morning sa mga staff niyo dyan sa ANC at mga inyong mga manonood. Magandang umaga sa inyo.
All right, Bear, I understand you only have 2 hours of sleep, so this will be very quick. Your reaction
to
the withdrawal by the DILG. First, the report yesterday that it issued a show cause order. Now it has withdrawn that show cause order less than 12 hours.
I have no words in my mind how to answer your question with all honesty because I'm focused on vaccinating people and protecting them. But maybe it's coincidence because the night before the chaotic situation in SM San Lazaro, supposed to be vaccination site, our website was attacked 133 times by hackers. But fortunately, with the help of some technological protection in protecting the data ng taong bayan, they failed. Tapos, alauna, alas dos na madaling araw, may dumating dito mga bus, van, mga sasakyan na punong-puno ng tao. Particular lamang sa isang site, no? Coming outside from Manila. As you all know, na Mike and Nikki, our vaccination is an open policy vaccination. And the logic behind is to really protect human being, immaterial, whether where they live, as long as they are walking around, we need to protect them. By doing so, we are already protecting ourselves. So I think yung approach ng Manila, there is a weakness to it, no? And it's being utilized also by some individual. Hindi pa napapahinga yung pagsusupil ng sitwasyon o siya naman lumabas itong DILG twice na yan, Mike, just for the information of our viewers. Pag-upo ko a few months thereafter, it's the same memorandum. Mm-hmm. Tapos ngayon naman, it's the same memorandum, and they said, ano sabi nila? Erroneous. Ano yung report mo kanina?
Inadvertent reissuance, Mayor. So you're confirming, Mayor, no, na meron na ngang nilabas sila na show cause order pagkaupo nyo noong 2019. Pero nireplyan nila ito? Sinagot ninyo? At naglabas pa ng panibagong show cause order kung sinagot nyo na ito?
Hindi siya, actually, Mike, hindi siya bago. It's the same.
It's the same. So yung petsa lang yung binago, July 9,
now,
2021 yung date.
It only proves that we are going nowhere with this pandemic. If this simple document, simple communication, it's going out in the offices. Naglakad mag-isa. Hindi naman siguro maglalakad mag-isa yan. So, but anyway, that's water under the bridge. Well, we continue to focus and we don't want to disturb smoke screen.
You did say earlier, sabi niyo, the night before that, the day before, no? The night before, nagkaroon ng attack sa website niyo. Then you have busload people coming to their vaccination sites, and then you have the DILG show cause order. Are you suggesting that all of these are actually coordinated attacks against you? Who could be behind this?
Hindi, sabi ko lang, baka natataon.
Do you think it's coincidence?
I don't know. It is not for me to. I'm just trying to help you survive, help your family protected by doing our job and be getting vaccinated. Mag-iingat tayo sa variant na D.
Mayor,
Delta pala.
Coincidentally, Mayor, yesterday you were supposed to take oath sa Action Democratico Party. Is that, do you think, coincidental that all of these came out as that supposed oath-taking? And, you know, many sectors are speculating that this move of yours, of switching parties, is actually just, you know, it lead all to your running for president in 2022.
Well, that's the least of my concern, with all honesty, Mike. We need to do those kind of things because kasama yon sa dapat gawin ng mga kakandidato sa Oktubre, no, kasi hindi naman natin pwedeng ikailaya mga yan. So, yan na yung anong posisyon. But that's the list of my priorities now, again and again and again. A few hours ago, we put about 11 million people under ECQ. The next question is, what are we going to do? May press release, may ayuda. At least, buti kayo, alam nyo na may ayuda. Pero kami mga mayor, wala pa kami tangan-tangan. Ganon din ang mamamayan. Buti pa kayo, may press release na nga sa inyo na may 4 million doses. Pero kami, ang tangan-tangan namin ay second doses lang. Ang second dose. And today, Mike and Nikki, wala kami backward today. Kasi wala naman kami pang first dose. So, the same problem since day one is still the same problem today. The same situation since last year is the same situation today. It's been a year and 6 months. We continue to what? Wash your hands, practice physical distancing, wear your mask. I believe so. That's the only way. We need to vaccinate people. The only way for us to survive, for your family to survive, is to keep our fellow men to be protected, and that is what you call vaccination.
Mayor, have you been able to talk to IATF and to perhaps Malacanang to ask them nasaan na yung ayuda, nasaan na yung vaccines?
Alam na nila yun. Hindi naman kailangan. Hindi naman lang kailangan. Kasama naman namin sila sa meeting. We were told. Kaya nga nasa inyo na yung press release.
Pero hindi pa dumadating. Were you given an assurance when that would arrive? Vaccines and the pandemic aid?
We'll see. Mahirap kasi magtiwala sa taong lagi kang binibail. Mm-hmm. Kaya we're trying to really survive in our own little way. Our system is not perfect the way we're doing it. But Mike and Nikki, numbers don't lie. 1.4 million doses, despite all the challenges, weather condition, hesitation before, which is ngayon wala na, convincing people to get vaccinated. 865,000, that's more than 70% of our qualified numbers, no? At 1,065,149, no? Out of that, 865 got the first dose. And out of 865, no, 600,000 plus got the second dose. This cannot be lied and denied. Mahirap ito. Hindi madali. Kaya kung bakit tayo naman, alam ko may yung ilan may mga masamang intensyon, mga kababayan, ulitin ko, hindi po perfecto ang sistema natin, pero at the end of the day, nagkakabakunahan tayo. Ilang buwan na tayo nagkakapilahan. Hindi man lang tayo nagkagulo katulad nung kahapon. Kaya kayo na po ang bahalang musa. But then again, we will continue to adapt. No? We will continue to innovate the way it was in drive-through vaccination. We will continue to go and create more vaccination sites. We will do 24/7. And I would need, you know, let me take this opportunity, 281 plus, 281 individuals with the call of the city government for bayanihan sa Manila, yung bakuna ang walang tulugan na mga tumugon. So nag-aantay lang kami ng bakuna. We're gonna do 24/7 vaccinations. We have to vaccinate as many people as possible and as fast as possible. Hindi kailangan ang politiko sa solusyon dito. Ang kailangan dito, bakuna, science, ang kailangan dito. That's what the people needs.
Mayor, narinig ko kayo kahapon, no? Aside from the fact na sinabi nyo na mayroong buses na dumating, you're also blaming the large number of people coming to vaccination sites to rumors being spread out. Supposedly, kapag hindi ka bakunado, ay either hindi ka makakalabas ng bahay o hindi ka makakakuha ng ayuda. But to what extent, Mayor, would you think that should the Manila government also look at your procedures? Kumbaga, sinasabi ng ilan, you should have an appointment system, you should improve your system para hindi magkaroon ng problema sa pila. To what extent do you think that's something that the Manila City government can do? And yung rumors naman, sino ang sinisisi natin, Mayor, for the rumors?
Well, I'm not a type of person who will go out in the evening and keep pointing fingers to others. I always look at the mirror. Now, as I have said, it's not perfect, but it delivers the objective. We are achieving it. Now, we will continue. Ang guarantee ko na lang sa iyo, Mike and Nikki, we will continue to innovate. We will continue to adapt to the challenges. But then again, that's why they call it mass vaccination. Because again, you do it by the numbers. You do it with the speed of time, no? Because COVID-19, walang kinikilalang holiday, walang kinikilalang Saturday o Sunday, walang kinikilalang ulan, bagyo. Unang-una, Mike, Nikki, kasalanan na nga naming gobyerno eh. Bakit? Eh dapat yung bakunan kung patumating. O eh ngayon eh, natakot pa yata ang tao kasi may mga kiyaw-kiyaw pa na ipakukulong sila, hindi sila bibigyan ng ayuda kapag hindi bakunado, hindi sila palalabas. I did not make that statement. Somebody did, no? That generate fear. And Mike, Nikki, nakikisuyo ako sa inyong dalawa. Huwag kayong papayag na mamuhay sa ilalim ng pananakot. We must continue to live peacefully, comfortably. We must move on and continue. Kailangan lang na nakapokus. But just an assurance, we will continue to innovate and adapt to the challenges of our day-to-day activities with regard to vaccination.
Mayor, listening to you now, I get a sense, at least it's my perception, are you blaming President Duterte for part of the chaos that happened in vaccination sites? You mentioned statements.
That's unfair.
It's not fair to blame the president. But to what extent do you think the president should be responsible for the statements that he made?
I don't know. I am no president. I don't know how hard to be president. But for the meantime, all local government units in Metro Manila is doing their job to get the job done.